All right, breaking news. Police in Kenosha, Wisconsin are searching for a man with a long gun, perhaps seen in this video that was seen on social media. Two people were killed overnight. The sheriff says there are armed vigilantes on the street. He even used the word militia to describe what is now happening in response to the protests over the death. Sorry, I keep saying that, over the shooting. Jacob Blake is not dead at all. He is in the hospital recovering. And this is exactly what Jacob Blake's family and mother said they did not want to see. This is the plea from Jacob Blake's mother to the American people.
People are just getting shot everywhere.
Do Jacob justice on this level and examine your hearts. As I pray for my son's healing physically, emotionally, and spiritually, I also have been praying even before this for the healing of our country.
Praying for healing. 3 days after Blake was repeatedly shot by police at close range in front of his children, we still don't have basic details on what happened. Joining me now is Reverend James Ward Jr. He led the emotional news conference yesterday and is a friend and pastor to the Blake family for more than 30 years. Pastor, thank you so much for being with us this morning. First, I just want, I guess, your reaction to the news overnight, the presence of armed militia men possibly on the streets of Kenosha. What's your prayer for Kenosha this morning?
Yeah, thank you so much for having me, John. What we're seeing in Kenosha is exactly what we did not want, exactly what Julia did not want. And as I opened the press conference yesterday with prayer, I'm continuing to stand. Intercessors, believers across the country, we're continuing to stand for the very best for Kenosha. And let me just kind of give you some context in terms of knowing Julia very well, having been her pastor, been associated with her family for more than 30 years. Some context of what's behind her plea to our nation and to the citizens of Kenosha is this. We're having conversations about criticism and controversy much more than we're having conversations about change and compassion. We're more concerned with right and left than we are right and wrong. And we need to call a ceasefire and come back and deal with the spiritual and the moral root. Julia, on several occasions, mentioned the heart. Examine your heart. We got to go back to the heart, being a Christian pastor, being Julia's pastor. Matthew chapter 15, verse 18, Jesus himself says that evil, murder, these things comes from the human heart and come from within to defile a man. And so if we're ever going to see true and lasting change in our nation, John, we got to get back to these spiritual and these moral roots from which we see these problems continuing to stem and this plague, this scourge in our society.
And that was Julia's message yesterday, even with her in the hospital, shot six or seven times, bullets in his back. That was her message for healing. How is Jacob doing this morning?
Yeah, as far as I know, I haven't gotten an update. We're giving Julia time to rest, giving the family time to be intimate together. We understand that he's still stable. He's doing relatively well. We pray, we thank God that his health is doing well. But we know as she made her plea, Jacob does not want this. Jacob, he shared his prayer. He had a time of prayer even before his latest surgery with his mom. And he himself is praying for peace and praying for things to be better in America. Just a reflection of the nature of this family that we're so blessed to serve and to be pastors and to be involved with.
So Jacob's sister had a different message. I'm not saying it's necessarily an opposing message, but a different message that I think was very interesting and worthy of note. She says she's not sad. She's done being sad. She said she hasn't shed a tear. What she says is she's angry and she wants the change now. Yep. What do you think is driving that? How do you respond to that?
I think that's a natural response. I mean, come on, if I touch a hot stove, if I'm in pain, if some pain is inflicted upon me, it is natural for me to cry out, to lash out. I think that's an understandable expression of a lot of the rage that we see across the nation. It's an emotion. And we know that as a pastor, I can tell you that oftentimes emotions are much more powerful even than our decision-making. It's why we fall in love with people that we know may not be good for us. We gambling problems, anger problems. I've done men's ministry. Emotions are very powerful. And so we have to take some time to diffuse the emotions, something that I call a zero victim mentality for us to act and not react so that we can develop some comprehensive solutions again to these issues that we're dealing with. Let me explain just some basis here in terms of what we're seeing. John, there are three types of law that govern every society: spiritual law, moral law, and civil law. People are generally familiar with civil law, but the two more important kinds of law are spiritual law and moral law. Civil law exists to either reward or punish people for breaking spiritual and moral law. We've got to get back to matters of the heart, whether that's with citizens, whether that's with police officers, black people, white people. We've got to deal with the human hearts, and we continue to bypass those primary conversations to deal with secondary issues. We got to go back to those. And I want to be here with Julia for us to introduce perhaps a new way of thinking, some new conversations in terms of how we can bring change to not see these events continue to happen over and over again. This time, I believe, with Julia's help, with the family's help, that if we come together, we can see change and see that these things are eliminated from our society.
I hope you're right. I mean, this time is different. Is a refrain we have heard before, though, in this situation. I do want to know what answers you feel like you need to begin this process. What answers do you want or need from police?
The answers, we have to let the family, which has a great legal team in place. I'm honored. I'm not an attorney. I'm a pastor. I was there for spiritual and moral counsel, and I'm still involved as the overall counsel working with the legal team. I have to let the legal team do the job of the legal team. My job is to come back to this place of talking about the heart. We've got to deal with the hearts of police officers. We've got to deal with the heart of people who are involved in the violence. We've got to deal with the hearts of politicians, the hearts of citizens, the hearts of clergy like myself. We got to come back to the root. I sometimes describe that it's a sin problem and not a skin problem. Sin is the root. Racism, these other things are the fruit. And John, you know what? If you keep picking the fruit off the tree and you don't kill it at the root, the fruit's only going to go back. That is why we hear calls for change each time, but we don't see change because we're not dealing with the root. The root is still strong. The root is still growing, and it's only going to produce more fruit. I think we deal with these things, we treat them as symptoms, and we never get to the virus. That is my job, and I want to call on the faith community to help engage, to work alongside the medical community, the legal community, law enforcement. We got to come together. But faith leaders like myself, we got to engage to get to the root, to the heart matter, and then we'll see the change. We never get that far, but we need to do that.
Pastor Ward, we appreciate you being with us. The family is lucky to have you. Kenosha is lucky
it's
to have
pleasure.
You. I hope people are listening. Thank you.
Thank you so much, John. Great being with you.